Okay, so we'll be going over this brand new feature called Claude Skills, and specifically how it's used in Claude code and how it differs from slash commands and subagents. So when I woke up this morning, I saw this feature come out and I grabbed my coffee and then basically read through all the announcements and documentation, and also Simon's blog, which he says that Claude Skills are awesome. Maybe they're a bigger deal than MCP, but I don't think it is a bigger deal than MCP, but I guess it really does depend on your use cases and how you're currently using Claude. I also did try it on the Claude application because it's available there. And if you go to settings, then you can go to capabilities and then turn on any of the desired skills that you can see here, or you can upload a zip file that contains your own skills. And I actually tried out one of these default skills, which is a Slack GIF creator, and you can see that I call the skill, and at least within the Claude web application, it mounts a bunch of things onto like a remote server somewhere, and then executes a bunch of the code until it makes the thing that is desired from the skill. And it made this like amazing GIF here, which is kind of weird, but hey. And of course, if I go to Anthropic Claude Skills page, then I can see the specific instructions that were given to that Slack GIF generator creator, as well as some of the templates that are available for the code, like the bounds, explode, animations, and also some of the core logic. And before going over the differences, I will show you how you can set this up and use this within Claude code. So there's much more documentation links down below in the agent skill section, but basically you want to go to your project, and in my case I have a project called HyperWhisper here, and within the .claude folder you want to create a new skills folder and then create a folder inside of that which is this name of the skill. So in this case I have code reviewer. And then you can define your skill on top with the name, the description, and that basically tells Claude when it will be used, because these skills are triggered automatically from Claude code. Like, Claude decides when to trigger them. So you can't like at a skill and have it triggered, but you can say like, hey, can you trigger the skill? And whereas slash commands, you trigger manually by actually running the slash command. And this description basically lets Claude know when it should be triggered. These are some of the allowed tools that the skill can use once it's enabled. And then this is a description of the skill itself. One of the things that you can do is add a bunch of examples or optional files. So you can create a new file and call it examples.md. So I can call it like examples.md, and then after creating the examples.md, I can say something like look at the examples, and then within brackets I can say examples.md, and that will link to that particular file in the same folder. And when Claude code is using this particular skill, then it will look at that file if needs be. And you can organize the files within subfolders and so forth, as shown here. So if you go to one of their skills, such as the MCP builder, then you can see there are a bunch of reference files, such as MCP best practices. And if you go to scale.md file, then you can see some of these reference files are used. So if I search like best practices, then you can see it's linking over to the best practices MCP file. And remember that skills are model invoked, so Claude autonomously decides when to use them based on the request and the skills description. This is different from slash commands, which are user invoked, because you have to explicitly type out the slash command to trigger it. So this skill that I made, which is a code review skill, I can go to a session of Claude code and say, what skills do I have available? And then it will show me the skills available, which is a code review skill and the release note skill. So I can then say trigger the code review skill to tell Claude to manually trigger it, or based on the description, it will be triggered automatically. And you can see it's loading in the tools that are available for the skill. It now read through the file of the skill. It's reading through the example file that we made earlier. And now it's gonna do the code review of the project based on the description of the skill. But it's probably not going to do a good job, because like the description of the skill is pretty bad. Anyway, so whilst this is running, let's compare it to subagents as well. I do have a previous video all about subagents that you can watch. It should be linked down below. But basically, after messing around with it and reading all the documentation that's available, some of the key differences are skills basically use a parent model, and subagents, you can define a different model that's used for that particular subagent. So when you're creating a subagent, you can choose whether Haiku is used, Opus is used, or just Sonnet is used instead. Or you can choose whether the parent model for that Claude code session is being used for the subagent. Another big difference is how the context window is handled within the skills. So skills, whenever they're triggered or run, they stay within the same context window, which means that you can follow up easily. You may have had a situation before where a subagent was triggered and the subagent decided to do something, but you can't follow up on the subagent, like what it decided to do, because whatever like context it had is immediately discarded and only the output is kept. So when you have a subagent, it looks kind of like this. You have your main main Claude code session on the left, and then it triggers a subagent and it gives it a system prompt, and then the subagent does some working, fetches all the files again. It basically is like an independent agent that doesn't know anything else besides a system prompt that was given to it. And then once a subagent has finished running, everything in the working is discarded, and then only the final output of the subagent is passed back to the main session. So that could be something like, I found X, Y, and Z bug, or I did A, B, and C changes, for example, and everything else here is discarded. Whereas when you're running a skill, like this part in red, which is a skill's like working or its logic or everything that it's doing, is actually kept within the main session. Another big difference is that when you're using a subagent, it's all defined within one file. So for example, I have this release notes generated subagent, and basically everything is within one file here. And in some cases, you can imagine your file getting like really long, so like 500, like 1,000 lines or something. And you can add additional stuff for the subagent, so you can say, look at this particular file if needs be, and have that bundled with your project, for example. But for skills, any additional context is progressively disclosed. So when you run a skill, only the skill.md file is loaded at once, and you can have dozens of additional files that are all bundled with the same skill and are only loaded when needs be. So you can see, for example, this MCP builder skill, you have a documentation library, and then you have some like specific implementations like TypeScript implementation guide and Python implementation guide, and then a evaluation guide. So for example, if you're working in a TypeScript only project and you downloaded a skill online, then you don't have like unnecessary Python implementation guide like logic clogging up the context for no. When this skill is triggered, it would know the project is a TypeScript project, and then it would only look at the TypeScript implementation guide when it comes to that particular skill. So yeah, basically because you can split a skill up into a main file, which is your skill.md file, and reference files, and have them loaded only when needs be, it means you're much more context efficient and you're not loading unnecessary information when you basically don't need to. When it comes to parallelizing them, like with subagents, you can chain them, so you can tell it to run one skill and then run another skill if needs be, but you can't really run them in parallel. Whilst Claude Code is able to run many tools in parallel, and skills are essentially tools, you will quickly fill up the context window and then it will basically be unusable. So it's much better to have subagents when you need things running in parallel. So ultimately the conclusion kind of here is that skills are more for lightweight, template-driven tasks. So when you have like a very defined way of doing something, such as when it comes to building a new MCP server, for example, like they showed in their example right here, then a skill can be very useful, and it's like a very well-defined task of either you successfully built the MCP server, like with the skill, or you did not. Whereas subagents are more for complex, multi-stepped like tasks that require a lot more context, and context that may be discarded later on. So that basically does mean that there is some kind of overlap, where I have level of autonomy on the bottom over here. Subagents have the highest level of autonomy, and slash commands basically have next to no autonomy. Then you have some overlap where you may come up with something that could be a skill, or it could be a slash command, or it could be a skill, or it could be a subagent instead. And it's for you to decide which is best and which is fastest for your particular context, depending on which requirements you have here, for example. So I have some examples over here. I have like one which is a PR formatter. So this is very template driven. You may have a set of systems in your company where your PR requests have to be formatted in a certain way. And having a skill can really help you with that. And if you just tell Claude, like, hey, can you now make a PR for this? Then it will know to trigger the PR formatter skill, because you will have defined the skill description to be like that. Skills can also be useful for very lightweight tasks. So if you handle a lot of images, for example, and you extract the metadata from the images using the EXIF formats, then you can basically define a skill of how the metadata that's extracted from the image should be handled, because like using a subagent for this particular thing is pretty overkill, and for a slash command you will have to trigger it manually. So you're seeing a recurring theme here where skills are most useful when you want standardized outputs and you have examples or reference documentation that you really want used. Whereas subagents are more useful when you're doing something like you want a code review of subagent, you want a lot of deep context, and you want it to forget that previous context and not to have it pollute the main Claude Code agent conversation. And another pretty useful way of using them is to have like a problem solver subagent. So when you're really stuck on a pesky bug, for example, you can spin up many subagents in parallel that basically try and figure out what the root cause of that bug is and all take different approaches and then combine that approach and then select the best approach. And I did make a separate video about this technique as well, which will be linked down below in the description. And in my own testing as well, I found that skills can call subagents. So you can see I made a release note skill that then calls a release notes generate a subagent, but I seem to be having a much harder time making a subagent call a skill instead. And I think that's probably something to do with the system prompt or the subagent, because it kind of forgets that skills are even a thing to begin with, so it doesn't call a skill. I'm sure that may be fixed soon and you will be able to have a subagent call a skill, but I'm kind of struggling to see a use case where you would want to have a subagent call a skill or have a skill call a subagent. Anyways, for my application Hyperwhisper, I will be making a brand new skill for this project. And what I did recently is I basically translate the entire application into Japanese. So basically every single string of the application is in this really long file over here. And I have the exact same file as well, but for Japanese. So you can see like this is how I'm basically translating the application into different languages. And what I'll do is make a brand new skill where every time Claude Code adds a brand new string into application, then it adds it into these two files here and it finds a relevant point to add it into. You can also do that with subagents as well, but because subagents are starting completely from fresh with a brand new context, it will take time to find that relevant like string that was recently added and then add it to the relevant files. Whereas I think by having it in the main session, it will be much faster and just do a better job overall. And if you do want to buy the application, it will be linked down below with a coupon code for those who are interested. And finally, if you have found the video to be interesting, then do subscribe to the channel because I do make these kind of videos whenever there's a big release or update within Claude Code or any other AI coding tools.